So what we've seen this week is we know what the markets care about. Number one, the markets care about Fed and rate hikes. We saw that this morning. We saw bond yields up, stock market down on concerns that the Fed might be aggressively raising rates. We know that the markets care about China trade wars and the strong dollar. We saw the S&P lose 5 or 6 points as the president made those offhanded comments. And we know that D.C. politics and the president's worries don't particularly move the market. You could see this just how the market reacted on the president's comments on trade. Look at all the usual trade stuff. Oil stocks drop. We saw metal stocks dropping. We saw China stocks all dropping. Those are the three typical examples. And if you don't think that the concerns about the Fed raising rates aren't, home builders were down big. And look at lumber. Lumber was limit down very briefly this afternoon, $15. In fact, it still is. $15 is limit down in lumber. So we've got these two issues that are floating out there, and those are the ones that are moving the markets, Tyler.
All right, Tim. Tim Ng, welcome. Good to have you with us.
Good to be back.
How sanguine are you about the market in light of the trade tangles that we're facing, and also in the next week or so, presumably higher interest rates?
Yeah, the markets, it looks like, are really discounting the present data versus what could happen over the next 6 to 9 months in regards to the trade wars. You know, at this point in time, you look at the economic data that just came out in the second quarter, GDP growth. Personal consumption expenditures were up 3.8%. CapEx was up 8.5%. And my favorite stat, Tyler, has always been, you know, the jobless claims are at 50-year lows. Why? Because my beloved Jets last won the Super Bowl in 1969. So those are great numbers from a historical perspective. But what the market effectively is saying is, additional tariffs, you're already seeing from the jobs report this morning that wages are up 2.9%. Added on the additional costs in terms of raw materials, et cetera, we've seen in the housing sector, how is that all going to translate in terms of higher costs and higher prices in terms of compressing
profits? And higher
profits,
interest rates potentially in response if the economy starts to pick up even more steam, right?
Absolutely. And one thing that's very interesting, if you look at the debt that's rolling off now, it's the first time since 2009 when debt that's going to be refinanced is going to be at a higher level as opposed to a lower level we had seen previously before. So everyone's going to be paying higher interest rates.
You still like the markets overall, though. You like information technology, financials, and consumer discretionary. Does that mean that you're fully allocated to equities at this point? What's your allocation like?
We're fully allocated to equities for our clients today. We're about 60% most at this point in time in terms of equities. We're really staying with the growth sectors. If you look at information technology, financials, in those areas, they're all growing at about 21%.
So you're looking through the possible costs of the tariffs either to the consumer and or to the corporation then?
At least on the short term, okay. At least for the next quarter to 2 quarters, yes.
How much are you factoring in emerging markets and the global economy, especially this seems to be where the trade talk starts to matter for people. Is that your biggest concern?
Yeah, our concern is emerging markets. Obviously, we've seen the effect, particularly on the currency side. So the currencies declining so much can push inflation rates as well. And overall, we're very much underweight in emerging markets. And the one thing that, you know, we talk about in regards to canary in the coal mines is the massive amount of debt that is sitting out there. We just saw what the actions China just took a couple of days ago in regards to permitting their financial institutions to increase their lending without paying a VAT tax at this point in time for the next 2 years. So they're telling you they're going to expand their balance sheet, and the balance sheets from the other central banks are still quite large.